What's up, everybody? Cigar Shipper Laird Mayhew back with another cigar review. Today, I've got the Joya de Nicaragua and Añtano, Connecticut, in Toro. Stay tuned.
I can smoke stogies in my house, first of all, because her father introduced me to stogies, and second of all, because I'm a stud. I'm ballsy. I don't take no shit from anyone. I smoke my stogie anywhere I want. I don't have to find a hideout place like you.
All right. Welcome back to another episode here at Cigar Sherpa. I, of course, am your host, Laird Mayhew. And if this is your first time here, boom, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Hit that little bell so you can keep up with what we're doing. And if this is not your first time and you are a return customer, welcome back. All right. As my intro said, today I've got the Joya de Nicaragua, Añtano, Connecticut. What is it? It's a Joya de Nicaragua, Añtano with a Connecticut wrapper. It's got an Ecuadorian Connecticut shade wrapper, Nicaraguan binder, Nicaraguan fillers. It's a Toro coming in at 6 inches by 50 ring gauge. That's all I know about it. Now, if you've been around the cigar world long enough, not even that long, and you know a thing or two about a thing or two, you've heard of the Joya de Nicaragua, especially the Añtano. What's it known for? Strength, okay? So we're going to see what the Connecticut version, you know, Connecticut's normally bringing in a more mild to medium, you know, light, mild, medium cigar. So we're going to see what a traditionally full-bodied cigar, full-strength cigar, reigns in with a Connecticut wrapper. So the construction on this thing is beautiful. It is, I mean, it's an Ecuadorian-grown Connecticut shade wrapper. I wouldn't know the difference. It's very nice. It's, for a light wrapper like this, it's got tight, damn near invisible seams. It's got a very, very nicely placed triple cap. A lot of time was taken. You know, it wasn't rushed, you can tell. Of course, you know, the band, it hadn't changed in a while, gold and red. The smell on the main body here off the wrapper is more of like a grassy hay. Very faint. Grassy hay might even be reaching for something because there's really no smell. But off the foot, it's got a very, very, like, sweet, earthy smell. Hints of dried fruit, maybe, but just like a good, earthy, damp, earthy Nicaraguan tobacco smell. So the only way we're going to know about this thing is if I give it a cut and a light, and I will do that and be back at the light up and tell you what I think about it from there. Stay tuned. All right. So initially, got a great draw, okay? Right off the bat, I'm getting a strong note of cedar. Sweet tobacco and black pepper on the retrohale for sure. Not much black pepper on the palate, so... Anyway, I don't know what you guys are doing today. It's Friday here. I don't know what part of the country you're in, but we had a blizzard last night that shut the entire state down. I woke up this morning and had probably about, I don't know, 3/4 of an inch of snow on the ground, not even enough to make it look blanketed. And of course, everything shuts down. I'm in the roofing and construction business, so, you know, I planned my schedule around just being off today. So I took care of all my morning stuff and I'm going to enjoy this cigar. Now, the reason why I've been looking forward to this cigar, I say I've been looking forward to it. I have smoked this cigar before, not this size. I smoked it back in October when I went to the Cigar Aficionado Big Smoke. It was one of the giveaways and I was very, very surprised at the strength coming out of Connecticut. It was a smaller cigar, probably the 46 ring gauge, but so far this thing has got good cedar, sweet tobacco, getting kind of leathery now, and good smoke output. But let me get into the first third more and come back and tell you what I think about it from there. Stay tuned.
All right. In the first third here, 9-10 minutes in, I ain't really been keeping up. So far, so good. It's almost damn near what I expected. It's a little bit less powerful than a smaller ring gauge. The smaller ring gauge. I don't remember what that was. I think it was a 46 or something, but I'm still got that good cedar. Smoke's gotten a little bit more creamy. The sweetness is kind of picking up on it. So it's got like a sweet, creamy smoke with that cedar. It has, of course, it's still got that pepper on the retrohale, but it has a kind of a spice to it, okay? It's not very pronounced. It's like, what cigar was it that I was smoking where I said, you're getting the effect of having a spice on it. Like the effect is there, but the flavor is not, hadn't really developed. It's like kind of working its way and like it wants to taste like a brown sugar, but aside from all that, it's just a really good, sweet, earthy tobacco. That would be the prominent. It's burning really good. It's medium bodied. So, you know, I'm probably smoking this thing a little too fast because it's burning really good. It's kind of getting a little wonky right there, but I think I'm just puffing on it because the smoke is creamy, but it's a light smoke. It's not a very thick smoke as of yet. So it kind of leaves you wanting more. You take a drag off of it, you take a puff, a draw off of it, and you get it and you blow it out. You know, you let the flavors kind of roll over your tongue, but then you immediately want that sensation again. So I'm going to slow down and get into the second third and come back and tell you what I think about it from there. Stay tuned. All right. We're in the second third here. We are right at about 30 minutes into this, down to the first band. And burning real good, smoking real good. It's a good medium body smoke. And overall, so for you guys that are not into flavor notes, tobacco wise, you know, just good tobacco, bad tobacco. This is a very good tobacco. It's a very mellow, very smooth, and very sweet tobacco. It almost like a hint of like brown sugar in there as it develops. And it's getting even better now that I'm like at the halfway point. But it's still got that note of cedar. It's got like a peppery spice. Okay, I won't call it like a black pepper. It's peppery. The retrohale's got a good spice to it. But it's not like full-on baker spice. It's like right in between. If you took black pepper and baker spice and then just, it's like a touch of it. So it's a very good cigar. It pairs up great with this coffee. And I'm drinking this, check out that cup, huh? I don't know if any of you guys are on the left coast out there. My wife recently got back from Portland, Oregon, and visited this donut shop called Voodoo Donut. Said it was really good. I guess it's really popular there. And the coffee that I'm drinking in there is also a Portland roast. It's called Hairbender. Very nutty. Just a good coffee. I don't know the brand that it is. It's a local shop there that does it. But pairs really good with this Connecticut cigar. I was drinking Coke before that, and it went really well. But, you know, I just figured it's cold out, and I felt like having a good cup of coffee with this nice Connecticut cigar. So, you know, woodsy, spicy, peppery, sweet tobacco. That's where I'm at right now. So sit back, enjoy what you're smoking, and I'll come back in the final third and wrap this thing up, tell you what I think about it from there. Stay tuned.
All right. We're in the final third, and I'm smoking this thing down. So if that's any indication of how good it is, well, there you go. I'm about 55 minutes into this thing, and since the last segment there where I left off in the second third, I was right at the second band, and as soon as I took that thing off, ashed it, and got it going, it really ramps up, and the flavor really steps up a notch. So overall, we were at a good, it was cedary. It had a good, like, sweet tobacco, slightly creamy smoke, and kind of a peppery spice nuance. But from the halfway point on till now, that spice picks up, and the cedar kind of takes a back seat, and that spice becomes more of a baker's spice and brown sugar, and the smoke just gets really creamy and almost bready. The texture of the smoke gets, it's creamy, but it's oily at the same time, and it's almost like chewy. And very, very good, complex flavor. Okay, so I was in one of the forums, and a question, you know, it comes up all the time, but one I really pay attention to was about the wrapper influencing the flavor on a cigar. And of course, there's guys that will tout that it doesn't lend any flavor, and then there's guys that say it's 90%. I don't know where I'm at. Probably about a good 50%, 40 to 50%. And This cigar might be a good example of that, because if I'm not wrong, this is the same Antano cigar. It just has a Connecticut, Ecuadorian Connecticut wrapper. Okay, and if you've smoked the Antano, the core blend, you know that's a full-bodied cigar and it's got a lot of strength to it. Well, you wrap this bad boy around it and it mellows it out, makes it a little bit more creamy, brings it down to a medium body. Even though in the last half of the cigar till now, the body kind of picks up, it's more on the plus side of medium, not quite full. Strength is still at a medium, but the notes I'm getting now, I wish the whole cigar was like that. I don't understand. I guess I'm in that sweet spot that people talk about, or maybe they pack in a little bit more Lajero there towards the end, just to kind of keep you on the cigar, because you know it was good, but it was kind of boring for me. But this last half has been really good. So I've still got that. Okay, so it's earthy core, sweet tobacco core, still there. The nuance that I'm getting is a baker spice and brown sugar and a bready, velvety smoke. If that makes any sense to you. If you're not a damn nuance guy, just really good, sweet, spicy tobacco. It's very smooth. Again, this is the Joya de Nicaragua Antano Connecticut Sporting Ecuadorian Connecticut Shade Wrapper. This is the Toro, so 6 inches by 50 ring gauge, and it's got Nicaraguan filler and binder. Good cigar. My favorite Connecticut? No, I'm still partial to the Romeo y Julieta Reserve Real. That's my go-to Connecticut cigar. I do like this better than the Camacho box press, though, so this may take its place. It's an expensive cigar. I guess it's on the north side. I think I paid about $10 for this, so Daily Arsenal. I mean, if you can catch a good deal at JR's or Cigars International or Cigar Bid, whatever it is that you like, if you can get them, you know, down in the $8 range when you catch them on sale, definitely a cigar I would smoke the beginning of the day. I would smoke it midday. I smoke it anytime. I even smoked this one before I went to bed, you know. So anyway, that's my thoughts on it. You smoke it and tell me what you think about it. Cigar Sherpa Larry Mayhew reminding you to be polite to everybody that you meet, but always have a backup plan in case you got to shoot him in the face. And I'm out.